story is coming out on Kickstarter on November 7th. And this is a really cool chance for you guys to watch what the game is really like. So, Peter, can you tell us what the game is a little bit about?
Yeah. The game is about controlling the two sorcerers between them. I mean, the duel between them. It's about the battle for London. So it's situated in the Victorian age, Victorian era. And in the Victorian era, when you control London, you control the whole world. So therefore, it is situated there, I mean, in the core set. So what you will do, you will build your own sorcerer at the beginning of the game, and then you match up your opponent who will also build his own sorcerer, mixing the different sets that we have. And then it is somehow like a hybrid between the collectible game and between the tactical skirmish board game. So at the end you have a board game feel, so it's a card-driven board game, as I can say.
The game is it looks really interesting. It had two sorcerers are battling each other for the control of these three locations in London. The design of the game, the artwork is fantastic. Rob, would people who have played Star Realms, Epic, and Heroes, would they actually be able to recognize themselves a little bit in the game?
So this game is very different from other games we've done in the past. There are a lot of components in the game. So you've got dice, you've got all the game boards, and as Peter said, it's sort of a mesh between a strategy card game and a tactical board game. Many of the elements of the White Wizard game will be familiar in that. We have a heavy card base. There's really beautiful artwork on the cards. A lot of attention to detail on the graphic design. But unlike our previous games where we've gone for small box, only card components, this is a large box game with a lot of really high quality components that will feel really nice when you play. The game does have a dark feel to it. There's a lot of evil monsters, dark magic. It's not a game to play with your 7-year-old, but for the grown-ups, this is some really cool stuff.
And this is the first game along the line that actually uses dice.
Yeah, so this is I've made many games in the past with dice, but not the White Wizard game. So this is our first dice game with a die element. And these dice are cool. They've got custom dice. They've got cool imagery carved into them that's very thematic for the game. And these dice are used in combat. So when your minions attack, they will roll dice equal to their combat. And when they get a skull result, that's going to be a point of damage that your opponent has to assign. When they get a double skull, they get 2 points of damage they have to assign. The white side is a miss, and the star is a critical hit, which you, the attacker, get to assign. And sometimes that'll mean you'll get to take out your opponent's guy before they get to attack back, or maybe you'll finish off the battlefield. And if you get 12 points of damage on your opponent's side of the battlefield, you're going to win that battlefield. And if you can win 2 out of 3 battlefields, you win the game immediately.
Excellent. So, Peter, you also said that you also have lots of energy things here as well, and that you, on your turn, you take after 6 actions, right? So, and this goes back and forth. Like, I take my action, you take your action, and it's right.
Every time, the same in the battle.
But it's very conflict oriented, so I have to decide that I hit your wizards, or do I have my focus on the battlefield, or how does it really work?
Yeah, it depends. I mean, it changes from the situation in which you are at the moment. It is like the game is separated into two acts, into two somehow like mini games. So the first part, the first act of the game is the action phase where you are preparing yourself to the battle. This not means that you are only putting minions into the thing. You are playing attachment cards, playing sorcery cards, but you're also preparing a really important element, and it is an omen tokens. I mean, these omens will allow you to force your opponent or yourself to reroll the die, so it will it can really change the pace of the conflict. So, like you said, we are alternating each other, so nobody will wait until the other player do all the actions. So we are constantly in action, in battle, also in during the action.
Well, that's a really excellent point. You constantly feel like you're part of the game because you're passing back and forth. You make a decision, they make a decision, back and forth throughout the game. And those omen tokens are really cool. Sometimes when you play a card, you'll get to gain an omen, and you can use those omen tokens to force a reroll on individual play. So while there's a die rolling mechanic, which has obviously a large element of randomness in it, you have you can re-roll dice when you think it's important to do so. So that gives you a lot of tactical control.
And to answer your question, when you will decide where to put your image is depending on what kind of minions you have. If you have some minions with a bigger essence, I mean bigger defense volume, so you can afford to put the damage into them, not into your battlefield, because it's really hard to restore the defense of the, because the battlefield count number, it's called defense, so you are, it's hard for you to restore defense. There are not many cards that will restore defense, so when you put damage into your side of the battlefield, it's done. I mean, you cannot turn it back.
Right. So it's also very, when I played it, it's also very fast. It's back and forth, back and forth.
Yeah.
There's almost no downtime at all, right?
No. There is.
Very good. So this game is coming out on Kickstarter on November 7th. So, and you can also check out that there's going to be some really cool artwork, as they said. There, you can see here, like, there are some cool cards. There are some minions you can play as well. And, of course, you can play tactics, different kind of strategies, and of course, lots of nice dice as well, tokens, you name it. So stay tuned for this one coming out November 7th on Kickstarter, White Wizard Games. The game is called Sorcerer. This is Martin reporting live from Essen 2017. Board Games with Niramas.
Be like Draco, follow Board Games with Niramas on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can find us at BGW Niramas.
Board Games with Niramas is sponsored by Alara Games in Sweden.